Well, good afternoon to all my student manager and faculty members. My name is Swapnil Birade.
And myself Vinit Desai, and we are from River Yamuna. So before starting presentation, let's look at a video, please. Lights off.
I guess everybody's woken up.
So, may I ask you one question, please? How many loves Volkswagen? Volkswagen, right, sorry. Exactly what I expected. Because, you know, Swapnil, it's, you know, I won the bet, bro.
It's my time. Yeah, you won the bet.
Swapnil had a bet because he said there are so many fans of Volkswagen here only, but I saw a few only. Just because of this, Swapnil already told you that if I asked, if I would have been asked the same question before 3 years ago, then definitely the result will be different. So, why I'm saying this, you can get to know by the presentation only.
So, today's topic is a case study on decline of Volkswagen in India. We'll, next. Our objective is the journey of Volkswagen being one of the most successful automobile industry to the surviving industry in Indian market. Exactly what happened in Indian market. And we'll go through history and overview, the journey of history and overview to the entry of Volkswagen in India, to the decline of Volkswagen in India, and lastly the conclusion. So history and overview is exactly, it was established in 28 May 1937 and it was founded by a Nazi, and the first automobile manufactured was type 1, that is Beetle. One second. That is Beetle, and it has a sales in 153 countries, around 123 production sales all across the global. The current CEO of Volkswagen Global is Herbert Diess, and the company drive is privately held. Currently, Volkswagen also owns 12 brands all over the globe, and in India they introduce 5 brands, that is Skoda, Porsche, Lamborghini, Audi and Volkswagen. This is the Volkswagen evolution as a brand. From the 1937, the logo was like that, you can see. And from there, it was evolved till 2019 as a original brand.
So, Volkswagen India. First of all, headquarters of Volkswagen India, which is in Mumbai, Maharashtra. And journey began with, the Volkswagen started the journey began with Skoda. And Skoda launched their first vehicle in market in 2001, which is Octavia. And second one is Volkswagen launched a globally successful after in 2007, because they tested their market with, in 2001, 2006, 2007, and in 2007 they saw there are so many it's huge market for vehicles, so that's why they get the Volkswagen in India in 2007. They started their first vehicle, they launched their first vehicle in India, which is which is Passat, which is already globally renowned brand it is. Then after that, they launched the Jetta in 2000. They launched a Jetta in 2008. After that, they launched Polo also. But after launching the Polo, they you know, get to know with they turned their successful life into the Indian market, because they got around 20% of their share, increasing share in the market after launching Polo. After that, their in 2010 they got their shares, and after that, they reintroduced a new all-new Passat, because they already introduced it. So they introduced new Passat in 2011. After that, they launched a Beetle, and then Ami was introduced. Ami was the first car which they introduced in a sub four meter category level. And Volkswagen has set up around 122 dealership in 113 cities. Last and the foremost is around 5,000 employees works at the various location in India. These are the competitors who compete with the Volkswagen. First of all, the one of the very famous competitor in India, which is Maruti Suzuki, because he's well and which is very old, and he have around 50% of market share in India. Second one is in second position, Tata is also there, and after Tata, Hyundai get the more percentage in that. After that, Toyota, Mahindra and Honda is the same competitor of Volkswagen. Revenue of the in 2016, which is as I told you, Maruti Suzuki have around 50% of revenue in 2016 as compared to Volkswagen in India. Volkswagen started their success up to the 2016 only. After 2016, they start falling drastically. So, as I told you while when I started the presentation, I asked for I told you that you will get to know about why I said that, because decline of Volkswagen in India, because after 2016 they started decline. They stuck with just 1% of market share from the 2% of market share, which is from which is financial year 2014. A loss of 37.1 crore which they get in 2018 as expected, because against a profit of 50.5 crore in 2017, because in 2017 they got the profit of 50.5 crores and a loss of 37.1 crores in 2018, because this drastically come into the they drastically falls. After that, the group has been seen its volume by 40% units down, because in 2016 they produced around 180,000 of units, and in 2018 they come to know that they reduced by 73,000 units per in the 2018. So this is a slight comparison why they get fall in the Indian market, because of what every features we have we can able to see here, which is comparatively same. But you know what, there are a service sector which they are not introduced well. In service industries they are not able to in services they are not able to catch small villages or like rural areas, so that's why they are coming in less profit. This is what the drastical lower they are coming lower, just as by year. Financial year 2014 they have units of 52,525. In 15 they are drastically come down, just because of MEO they launched in 2015. The graph goes above. So this is just overview of which I told you before. This is only about the Polo, because Polo get around if they got a profit of 100%, then Polo have sustained the market in India around 60%, which is the profit which is given by Polo only, and other brands which are like they're not much able to get thing.
So the reasons of declination of Volkswagen in India was the production line was old, and as Stephen Knapp, the director of Volkswagen, already told that the technology was 8 years old, and there was in US there was a Dieselgate scam, so that's why their image was tarnished. drastically, and their service costs are high, and basically the products, Volkswagen spare parts, are should be bought from Volkswagen showrooms only. They are not collaborated with the local trades, and overall dispatch satisfaction with the service provided. These are the SWOT analysis: strengths, weaknesses, opportunity and threats. Strengths is a high brand recognition. Everybody knows what Volkswagen is, and a very well structured umbrella brand all across the world, 153 countries. The negative weakness was the basically the publicity because of the Dieselgate scam. The image was tarnished drastically, and the lowest market share in India and US.